This is a podcast from the Angel News Network with author Joel Anastasi interviewing Ashtar, commander of the Galactic Federation of Light, as channeled by Philip Elton Collins.
Greetings, beloved, beautiful human beings of the planet Earth. We come to you from the Galactic Federation of Light. We are a council of beings who service many of the planets within your galaxy. Many, many of them. At this time, your particular planet is in the process of waking up to its divine soul plan of being and applying love, which is the purpose of the creation of this particular planet. As many of you know, many star systems and beings of light came together within the creation of this particular planet. It has gone through many, many epochs of advancement, not always forward, but back and forth, but always ending up forward. It is called the ascension process of this particular planet, and we have been observing it since the beginning. At this particular time, we are housed on your planet Saturn, where we are observing many activities on your planet. We remind you briefly of your ancient history of the Anunnaki who came from another part of the galaxy and genetically engineered what became human beings. We remind you of your ancient past assertive Atlantean energy, which is expressing itself now in something that is called the Cabal of the Illuminati. But each of the individuals has a soul plan, a divine plan to be a part of your ascension process and have chosen it on one level. Again, we are monitoring the current activities that is happening on your planet within the process of creating what is called collective, conscious, unified energy. You are divine beings of light and are waking up to that reality more and more. Your current events, specifically regarding your Ukraine situation, is about a further awakening up. It is about an event that has allowed more and more of you to become aware of what is taking place on your particular planet and deciding individually and collectively what you may do and do about what you may do and be about it. Remember, each soul plan has a planet. In your case, you are a lover of diversity, learning to apply the building blocks of all creation love. Each nation, each individual also has a soul plan, and all of you are within the process now, particularly with the current events which you're creating on your planet, of activating those soul plans to understand how they interface and interact with a nation's soul plan or a planetary soul plan. You're all actually receiving everything you need to move forward within that process. For everything that you're creating is not a punishment, it is a learning tool of your going forward. Again, you're waking up from a long, deep sleep. We will continue to monitor what's going on your planet, and as has been explained to you in the past and the present, if there's ever a threat, a sincere threat, an immediate threat to the survival of the planet, we will step in, which we did with the Atlantean civilizations not so long ago, when they had the technology and the ability to destroy the planet. What we are observing at this time is not that necessarily taking place. So remember, each one of you have chosen to be, in your vernacular, a character within the soul plan of the planet, within the soul plan of you being an individual. Let us begin a dialogue and see if we can further clarify what's going on and the support that you have always had from the higher realms, particularly in this case, the Galactic Federation. How may we help you? I am Captain Ashtar, speaking for the Federation.
Captain Ashtar, it's an honor to speak with you. Thank you for joining us.
It is our honor to do so.
You of course outline what is clear to some of us, at least, that this is certainly, this invasion by Putin's Russia of the Ukraine is certainly waking up the world's consciousness to realize what the implications of authoritarianism really is, because over the past several years, especially since Donald Trump, and before him really, but when Donald Trump became our president, the authoritarianism seemed to be gaining favor and strength throughout the world. And I think this invasion and the monstrous consequences are waking everybody up to what authoritarianism really means and represents.
Can you begin to see how each of these individuals is also playing a role in the advancement of the planet?
Yes, we've been told that Trump, on an elevated level before he came to Earth, agreed to play the role that he played, to threaten our democracy so that people could really understand that America was not fulfilling its mission to bring peace, love, equality, harmony, and balance to the world.
And it is your choice, through your residence and your discernment, which you have been taught by the higher realms, to apply from that learning experience. But with your communication and your transportation being what it is now, you're able to see almost in live time, if you will, exactly as what is taking place in order to make a decision. And what that decision, if it is a positive one, will gender and create within the human species is a compassion for your fellow man. And once you have that compassion as a human being, you can develop that state of being into a positive action of doing by awakening all the nations of the world and allowing the voice to be heard with the current transportation communication like it has never been before.
Well, we're looking at this situation where it's a little bit like watching a bully kill people, and we're all standing there watching this happen, and we're afraid to become involved because of the possibility of the nuclear response on the part of Russia. You said that you don't become involved unless there's an immediate threat to the survival of the planet. Is that not a real threat that Putin and Russia represents to annihilate with nuclear bombs?
Is not an immediate threat. The bully, as you would call this divine soul, is putting that out there in order to create fear. Your leaders are prepared to act in an aggressive way if necessary. What is being evaluated at this time is exactly how that would take place beyond the matters of sanction which have taken place at this time.
Well, I understand that, but you know, as you stand and watch more and more people being killed, you have to wonder, what are they waiting for? For more people to be killed? What has to happen before they decide to come and defend these people physically and not just economic sanctions?
On a soul level, which we've addressed partially at the beginning of this conversation, each individual who is choosing to leave their bodies or this frequency at this time, see it as a sacrifice, an aspect of their soul plans, which they may become fully conscious of once they leave their bodies. Do you understand that?
Yes, I do. And what is important for anybody, to those who are listening to this, is to realize, there may be some people listening to this podcast who have heard what you just said for the first time. So just for clarity, could you repeat the teaching that you just gave about the agreement people have made?
The most important thing to understand is there is no death, that you are eternal spiritual beings and you are formatted in an energetic spiritual beingness that can never die, that you've had many, many lifetimes on this particular planet and other planets which we observe through millennia. That is the most important thing to understand. Within your incarnational cycles within each planet, this one or others, you may make a decision to sacrifice that physical life for the advancement of that specific planet, in this case, planet Earth. All of this is called a divine order, which you have heard. But to understand life is to understand death. To understand death is to understand life. Do you understand?
Yes, you're creating a vital spiritual context for people to understand what's going on in our 3D world right now.
You're all the creators creating what you need to create, the way you need to create it, in order to learn the way you need to learn it. The current events that are taking place in your Ukraine are what is exactly necessary at this time to wake up the deep slumber of most of humanity.
Saint Germain said this to us in one of our discussions when he was talking about the role that Donald Trump was playing in America, that people were becoming increasingly alarmed that our democracy was under threat. And this is what Saint Germain said: it is happening now, meaning what Trump was doing, as we have discussed, to awaken humanity to the preciousness of democracy and to understand that democracy is not a spectator sport and involves the participation of all of you. Is that what this current tragedy doing for the entire world, awakening people to the preciousness of democracy?
Exactly. Awakening themselves to the event and how it affects them and their relationship with themselves, developing a compassion for self, thus a compassion for others, and realizing that you're all diversified versions of one another from the same source.
So tell us, what do we do as we watch the... apparently, Russia is increasing the violence, and they're expanding the destruction, and they're destroying one city after the other. And I believe Ukraine has 50 nuclear plants, and there's the... belief that they're going to be targeting those plants would create an international tragedy, needless to say. So what do we do as we, you said we're watching this in real time, we are. So what do we do as we watch Russia continuing to fulfill its plan to destroy the country and kill as many people as they need to?
Continue to build the collective consciousness, the planetary consciousness, surround the entire country of Ukraine with that consciousness and that intention, and know the power of that energy. Also know you are not alone. There are many forces within the higher realms, not just we of the Galactic Federation of Light, but the Archangelic realms, the Inner Earth realms, the Star realms that seeded your planet, just to name a few. We are here, all of us, monitoring you, understanding what you call suffering, understanding the plight that has been created, and understanding the role playing and the soul choices that individuals have made to awaken humanity. If and when the planet becomes threatened, truly threatened, we will have a dispensation of the higher realms to step in and prevent that process. You have heard many, many times, dear one, that the planet will ascend with or without humanity into a being of light, what you would call a star. If you look up into your night sky, all of those stars were once a planet who went through an ascension process. You're going through there. There are enough of you who have already awakened into a collective consciousness. That ascension of the planet and humanity together is assured.
You know, I want to end our conversation on a positive note. I want to just read for so that those listening can hear this. Within the last week, we had a conversation with the Dhamma, who's the father of mankind, and he said this: demand that your governments unite in oneness to give full support and protection to Ukraine and all the nations of the former Soviet bloc, to defend them and to let them feel the entire global brother sisterhood of love and compassion around them. I must say, it feels as though that's exactly what's happening.
See the entire nation of Ukraine surrounded by this loving, supportive, collective planetary consciousness filtering into every point of the country. to enter into the fray at present, but to become a part of it. Allow the in knowing of your inner energies, your eternal energies, moving forward into the country of Ukraine. Allow that to take place. Trust in it and know that it has an effect. Know that you are not alone within this process. Know that everything is being created or soul plan characterizations acting out in divine order. Know this, trust it. Bring this wisdom into this current event beyond the past wars. And then humanity will wake up and be able to say, war won't work anymore.
That was a very powerful statement. Thank you so much, Esther. And thank you for joining us.
You are welcome.